Hi guys, welcome to the channel. So in this particular video we are going to discuss a case in which we are going to find out electric field at the center due to distribution of charge along 1/4 part of a circle. So suppose this is 1/4 part of a circle and this is the reference center. Okay, the positive charge, suppose positive charge is distributed along 1/4 part of this circle, and due to this charge distribution, this positive charge distribution, we need to find out how much of electric field is there at this point O. Now what we are going to do is, as always, we are going to cut a small length DL, okay, a small length DL having small charge DQ. Okay, suppose overall charge along this 1/4 part is capital Q and this small length DL carries small charge of DQ. So due to this small charge DQ, there will be some amount of electric field at this point O in this direction, designated as DE, small field DE. Now this length DL is subtending an angle of d theta, a small angle of d theta from this center, and from this horizontal it is having at an angle of theta. This length DL is at an angle of theta, subtending an angle of d theta from the center. Now what we need to do is, as always, we are going to find out the components of this DE. Now this will be the reference horizontal line and this will be the vertical line, right? Now if this angle is theta, then this angle is also going to be theta because these are vertically opposite angles. So along this theta there will be a component of DE cos theta, we know that, and at 90 degree from it there will be component of DE sine theta. Right, now these are the components. Now because this component is along the horizontal direction, so I am going to designate this component as EH, that is horizontal component, and this one as EV, as the vertical component, right? So what will happen now is that all the components of electric field which are along this horizontal line, I am going to designate them as EH, and all the components which are going to be along this vertical line, I am going to designate all those components as EV, right? Just like this one, there will be many lengths DL and we are going to find out their corresponding electric fields and their vertical and horizontal components. The summation of all those vertical and horizontal components will be EV and EH respectively, right? So basically what I am saying is that EV will be what? EV will be integration of all these components, EV is, yes, sine theta, right? And EH will be what? It will be integration of DE cos theta. Now what we know is that E net will be what? It will be under root of EV square plus EH square, right? This we know. Now we need to find out EV and EH. We will substitute the values and we can get E net. Now what is DE here? Now DE is what we know, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught DQ by, suppose this length is R, small r, so it will be DQ by R square. Now we can also write it as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Instead of DQ we can write lambda into DL, this we know now, right? So instead of DQ we can write lambda into DL by R square, right? Lambda is charge per unit length. Also we can write it as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by R square. Instead of DL we can write down R d theta. This also we know using the formula, theta is equals to arc upon radius right? What we can get is, here angle will be d theta, arc is dl, radius is small r. So substituting the values, we can get, instead of dl we can write down rd theta. So 1 r with cancel out with 1 r, so we will be left with d is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r d theta. Now first we are going to find out eh. eh is what? Integration of dE cos theta. Here we will substitute the value of dE from here and then we will integrate. So what we will be getting is eh is equals to integration of dE is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r d theta cos theta, right? Now we will take out the constant, so it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r integration of cos theta d theta. Now theta here is varying from 0 to pi by 2, right? From 0 it is starting and ending at pi by 2, so it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r integration of cos theta is sine theta limits 0 to pi by 2. Now we will substitute the limits. It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r upper limit minus lower limit. Sine 0 is 0, sine pi by 2 is 1. So 1 minus 0 will be 1. So basically we are getting eh is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r. This is eh, that is summation of all the horizontal components. Now we will try to find out ev. ev is what? Integration of dE sine theta. So it will be what? ev is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r d theta sine theta. Now we'll take out the constants. It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r, sorry, integration of sine theta d theta. Again theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2, so it will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r integration of sine theta is minus cos theta limits. Now I'll just take out the minus outside. It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r and minus here, and now we'll put the limits, upper limit minus lower limit. Cos 0 is 1, cos pi by 2 is 0. So inside the bracket we have minus 1, so minus minus will become plus, and we will be left with ev is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r, right? So now you can find out e net here. You just have to see ev and eh both have same values, right? So I'm just directly writing what you will get instead of e net. If suppose I'm writing 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r as capital, say as capital P, okay, I'm writing this whole as capital P. So e net will be what? Root 2 of P. Okay, you just have to multiply this overall value by root 2, you will get e net. You need to solve this by yourself. What happens is, if we are having two components, right, ev and eh, both are same values. So suppose these are having values of P and P, so e net here will be root 2 P, right? We need not solve that, we know that. So that's why I have said that if instead of whole of this I'm going to write it as P, so e net will be root 2 of P, that is root 2 multiplied by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda by r. So that will be e net. You can solve this also. So substitute the values of ev and eh in this equation, you will eventually get the result as this one. Okay, so you can solve this one also, or you can just directly write it down as I have written it, right? So I hope this video was useful for you. So far, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.